warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today I am going to present the financial accounting report of Wattan Industries, which are the company that take as the references of our own financial accounting report. So I am going to introduce our group member, which is me, Aisyah Fahmi Muhammad, second is Dalia binti Muhammad Noor, Auni Akhila binti Arifin, and Asmira Syakika binti Abdul Ashab. So we have list our own content for our own project, which is the first is basically the introduction of the company background, profitable ratio, liquidity ratio, efficiency ratio, references and appendix. Okay, so the introduction of the company background. So basically, Wattan Industries Berhad is one of the premiers and the longest company manufacturers in Malaysia in the biscuit market, which is the company is established since 1962, and due to their progressing their own company, they have listed down in the stock exchange Malaysia, which is Bursa Saham Malaysia, in 1992. Because of the company have grown successfully, they become one of the largest players in the biscuit industry in the country and produce a fine wide range of superior quality biscuits. Next, the company has successful in their own market domestically and internationally. Wattan have created their own trademark of brand, which is Wattan and Luxury. And although Wattan company have listed on top 50 countries, have listed on 50 countries around the world, which is top company in around the world. Okay, because of their own progressing on comprehensive and extensive network, the Wattan Industries Berhad also carrying their own products and brands to other principles of the Malaysian market.
Thank you. for every 100 sales, what industry net profit is RM 0.60%. After deducting operating and non-operating expenses, the net profit margin increased from RM 0.60 in 2016 to 1.57 in 2017. So the net profit margin from Pantai Industry in 2016 is 0.60 because which is less than 1 ringgit. There is a lot of selling and distribution expenses. What time may want to investigate on their increase on their high selling and distribution expenses. Okay, next is return on investment. Return on investment is a perform measure used to evaluate the efficiency of an investment or compare the efficiency of a number of different investments. So the formula is return on investment equal to net profit after tax over total asset times 100. For year 2017, return on investment for water industry is 1.66%. The interpretation is for every 1 ringgit generated on sales, water investment has return on investment 1.66 ringgit. In 2016, return on investment for water is 0.60%. For every 1 ringgit generated in sales, water industry has return on investment 0.60 ringgit. Cents. Return on investment for water has increased from 0.60% for the year 2016 to 1.66% for the year 2017. The highest of the return investment, the more efficiency of the company to use the asset to generate asset. Water has better return on investment on 2017.
Show and analyze the ability of a company to pay of both its current liabilities as they become weak as well as their long-term liabilities and they become current in other words. This ratio shows the cash levels of a company and the ability to turn other assets into cash to pay off liabilities and other current obligations. So we have two ratios commonly used are that is current ratio and asset plus ratio. Okay, first, current ratio. The current ratio is a liquidity and efficiency ratio that measure a firm's ability to pay off its short-term liabilities with its current asset. The formula for current ratio is current asset over current liabilities. So for the year 2017, the current ratio is 1.30 times. And for interpretation, for every 1 ringgit current liabilities, Pantai Industry has 1 ringgit 36 current asset to meet their immediate financial obligation. For 2016, the current ratio is 1.23 times, and for every 1 ringgit current liabilities, Water Industry has 1.83 current asset to meet their immediate financial obligations. The current ratio for Water Industry has been increased from 1.23 in 2016 to 1.30 in 2017. It shows that Water Industry has a current asset surplus of 1.23 in 2016 and 30% in 2017. For the asset plus ratio, the asset plus ratio is a liquidity ratio that measures a company's ability to pay off its current debt with only liquid assets. The formula is current asset minus inventories and minus repayments over current liabilities. For the year 2017, the asset plus ratio is 1.08 times. For every 1 ringgit current liabilities, the liquid asset is 1.08. For 2016, the asset plus ratio is 1.001 times. For every 1 ringgit current liabilities, the liquid asset is 1.01. The asset plus ratio for water industry has been increased from 1.01 in 2016 to 1.18 in 2017. It shows that water has sufficient to meet the immediate financial obligation.
Next ratio that we going to explain is F. efficiency ratio. Okay, basically efficiency ratio measure how well companies utilize their own assets to generate income. This shows how they use their own assets in a way to give their own company income. Efficiency ratio often took at the time it takes companies to collect cash from customer, or the time it takes companies to convert inventory into cash. So basically there are two ratios commonly used, inventory turnover ratio and average collection ratio. Okay, inventory turnover ratio is the inventory turnover ratio is an efficiency ratio that show how well the company managed to comparing cost of goods sold with average inventory for a period. Okay, basically inventory turnover ratio is how well the company managed to make in or out inventory, how many times that they can do. Okay, the formula is cost of sales divided by average inventory. So in 2017, the inventory turnover is 6 times, which is the interpretation one time will be able to replace the inventory 6 times in one accounting period. This is show how well they manage their own inventory in the company. Okay, in 2016, inventory turnover is 6 times. What time will be able to replace the inventory 6 times in one accounting period. So the conclusion is the duration of the year is still the same from 2017 and 2016. Okay, next is average collection period. Average collection period indicates the average number of days elapsed between a credit sale and the date of the company received the payment from the credit sale. Average collection period formula is trade and other receivables divided by cost of sales times the days in the 1 year, which is 365 days. Okay, the shorter the days they have collected, the better the performance of the company. Okay, so in 2017, the average collection period is 180 days. So the interpretation is what time will able to make collection for their credit sale within in 180 days. So in 2017, average collection period is 175 days. What time will able to make collection for their credit sale within 175 days. If this one is 2 years, we can conclude that 2017 is better than 2016 is better than 2017. Because of the period of the collected receivable. So the average collection period for water industries has been decreased from 180 days in 2017 to 175 days in 2016. It is not efficient because water industry take almost half of 2 years to collect the debt from the debtors. So this is our references. How to calculate the ratio. So our appendix is statement of financial position, statement of comprehensive income, statement of changes in equity,